Today's random object. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And click the bell so you'll be notified of upcoming videos.
The first successful English colony was Jamestown, established May 14, 1607, near Chesapeake Bay. The business venture was financed and coordinated by the London, Virginia Company, a joint stock company looking for gold. Its first years were extremely difficult, with very high death rates from disease and starvation, wars with local Indians, and little gold. The colony survived and flourished by turning to tobacco as a cash crop. By the late 17th century, Virginia's export economy was largely based on tobacco, and new, richer settlers came in to take up large portions of land, build large plantations, and import indentured servants and slaves. In 1676, Bacon's Rebellion occurred, but was suppressed by royal officials. After Bacon's Rebellion, African slaves rapidly replaced indentured servants as Virginia's main labor force. The colonial assembly shared power with a royally appointed governor. On a more local level, governmental power was invested in county courts, which were self-perpetuating. The incumbents filled any vacancies, and there were never popular elections. As cash crop producers, Chesapeake plantations were heavily dependent on trade with England. With easy navigation by river, there were few towns and no cities. Planters shipped directly to Britain. High death rates and a very young population profile characterized the colony during its first years. Randall Miller points out that America had no titled aristocracy, although one aristocrat, Lord Thomas Fairfax, did take up residence in Virginia in 1734. Lord Fairfax was a Scottish baron who came to America permanently to oversee his family's vast land holdings. Historian Arthur Schlesinger says that he was unique among the permanent comers in bearing so high a rank as baron. He was a patron of George Washington and was not disturbed during the war.